Today we will discuss about Rousseau, what was the philosophical belief of Rousseau and what was the educational philosophy of Rousseau, and we will discuss about two important work of the Rousseau. However, there is a lot of work of Rousseau, and Rousseau is a philosopher who have influenced in the diverse field of the society. Diverse field of the society means even in the sociological aspect, even in the philosophical aspect, even the political aspect, even in the educational aspect. In the so many area he has influenced the world. Okay, so he is such a great philosopher. But the two important work we will be discussing here, that one work is the his book. His book name is Email, hana? That we will discuss together with the philosophical belief of the Rousseau and the educational philosophy of the Rousseau. Email we will be discussing. And why it is required to discuss Email? Because in the different book he used to discuss the different philosophical problem, like a political problem, sociological problem, problem of society. Like that, Email is a book where he is discussing the educational problems. And we are mainly concerned towards the educational philosophy of the Rousseau. So that's why we will discuss the Email. And the second thing that we will discuss in detail is that the concept of negative education. Because he has given a concept of negative education. It sounds very different when we talk about the negative education, because we all are talking about the positive and we are searching for the positivity. And Rousseau is the person who is talking about the negative education, the education should be negative. So what is the negative education? What is its philosophical belief for the negative education? All those things we will be discussing in detail. But before the discussion, we will see the Rousseau and the life of a Rousseau, because we are saying repeatedly that in order to understand the philosophical belief of a philosopher, we must understand the life of the philosopher, which is shaping their life and making them to think in that direction. Okay, so that's why. When we talk about the Rousseau is the person who brought a remarkable change in the social and a political structure of many countries. It is not like that the France or something. It's a many country he has influenced by his social and political thoughts. So he has affected the social and political structure of many country through his educational ideas of three things, that is the liberty, equality and fraternity. So this three idea was propounded by the Rousseau, and by this three idea he has made the world to think about that. So he become a center of a think, that this three new idea was given by the Rousseau. He is also considered as a father of civilization, as he has influenced our thinking in a many ways. And we know that the civilization is actually a process of developing the thinking process. As and when you will start thinking, and when you will start thinking in a diverse way, then we can think that the civilization, the process of civilization will be accelerated, isn't it? That's why he is termed as a father of a civilization also, because he made us to think in a very different way. Even he has seen the education differently. Just I was talking about the negative education, that we will be discussing in detail in the coming times. Okay, so it's a very promising and very different kind of philosophical belief and a system he had. He has also highlighted that the evil of a society, how the evil of a society works and how it influences the child, and wanted to reform by its modifying the process of education according to the need and interest of the individual in the society. He was talking about the evil. What is the evil of a society? And how we can reform and modify the process of reform that by the process of education. And the education which is the need and interest based of an individual and a society. Even we used to talk about that, that the education must be contextual in nature. Education must be as per the need of the individual and a society. And he took in both in the 17th century, 1712, and 1712. He took both at that time in the 17th century, and this is the 21st century, and still we are talking about the education must be aligned toward the productivity of the person and the productivity of the society. You can think about that, how much progressive thought he had. Even due to the progressive thought of the Rousseau, the people, the governance of that time were not accepting the Rousseau. I will talk about that also. When he come up with his writing, Email, he has been expelled from the France. And the copies of Email were burned in the Parliament of France. So you can think that how progressive thought the Rousseau was having, so that even their thought was not acceptable, not digestible at that time, which you can link their thought to the present situation, and you will find that how much it is relevant to the present time. Okay, and of course, when we see the philosophy of Rousseau, you will find that Rousseau was one of the prime exponent of the naturalism. He was a naturalistic philosopher. He was promoting the naturalism, isn't it? And he was a great educator even. Even he was a great philosopher, great sociologist, great political thinker, but a great educationist also. Because he has worked, he has contributed constructively in the field of education. And he was a great educator of the 18th century. And since he has influenced the political aspect of our life also, so he is known as, he was a key person behind the French Revolution. I think you must have heard about the French Revolution in the history subject during your school time.
Yes, sir.
So he was the father of the French Revolution. French Revolution means he was not like that. He was revolting, or he was gathering the people. He was writing, and through his writing, the French Revolution emerged because of its philosophical ideas, because of its educational ideas, because of its political idea, which was not digestible at that time. The governance was not digesting their ideas because it was a progressive idea, revolutionary idea, isn't it? So they were not able to digest that. When we see the Rousseau, Rousseau was born in the small city of Geneva in 1712, and he lost his mother soon after his birth, and he has been brought up by his father. But his father was a private tutor and a poor watchmaker who was unable to take care the child Rousseau and nurture the child Rousseau properly. And as a result of that, what happened? Child Rousseau was come in contact with the bad habits, and due to the bad habit of a child Rousseau, he was beaten in the school. He was beaten in the school very badly, which has affected the mind of a child Rousseau very badly. And this, after this incident, he started opposing the unhuman practices in his school, that the child were beaten, the education was not child centric, the education was given what the teacher is thinking. So he was beaten, and after that he opposed the unhuman practice in the schools, and at last he left the school because of two things. One thing is that we know that his father was not very much economically sound, so he has to help his father for earning the livelihood. For earning the livelihood, he was supposed to his father, isn't it? And the third next thing was, since he was beaten in the school very badly, so he was disheartened from the school. So he left the school at the age of 12 years and tried to engage himself in a different sorts of occupation. But the child Rousseau, at the age of 12 years, he failed in any one of the profession. So he was wandering here and there from one place to another place, and he was meeting to a different people. And by meeting the different people, he was talking to them and he was exchanging his ideas and he was learning from the people's interaction. But anyway, that will not work for the livelihood. So he was getting the sympathy of the people and it was a learning also, and he has developed the sympathy with the poor people also. But because of the hungry and because of he was wandering here and there, he found out by one priest. One priest saw the child Rousseau. The name of the priest was Savoyard Vigor, and he took the child Rousseau to his home and fed up. So feeding, he feeded the child Rousseau. This incident saved the life of a child Rousseau and the character of the child Rousseau, because he had a very vast experience. Education he was not having, but he had a very vast experience with the interacting with the people, sufferings of a people, poverty of a people. And he also saw a people, a person who took his home, given a food, given a shelter, and that's why he was very much affected, and he was saved by that priest. Slowly, slowly, he started becoming familiar with the existing social and the philosophical problem. Because he was, while he was wandering for the job, for a livelihood, he was meeting with the various people. So he started understanding the social and the philosophical problem. And then he started, he was also affected by the writing of the Hobbes, Pascal, Kepler, Newton, and other writers, other philosophers of that time. And we know that they were the excellent in their field, like Newton, Kepler, Pascal, Hobbes, all they were very excellent philosopher, excellent scientist in their field at that time. So he was influenced by their writings also. And then he, after getting the influence from all those things, he started thinking and writing about the education and the governance, that how the education should be, because he was a sufferer of education and he was also a sufferer of a, you can think that the governance, because he was seeing the poverty, the condition of the people very closely. So he started thinking about the education and the governance. But by side, for earning his livelihood, he started his hand in some profession, because he had to earn his livelihood. So to earn his livelihood, he started doing some profession, like a private tutor, like a music teacher, like a secretary, like a composer, dramatist, all he was trying to earn his livelihood. And finally, in search of his livelihood, he settled in the Paris in 1741. He settled in the Paris and he became a writer. Rousseau, but the Rousseau was particularly influenced by the poverty and the suffering of a people. He was seen these two things very closely. One was the suffering of the people, another was the education. So these two things the Rousseau has seen very closely. That's why when you will see the writing of Rousseau, the political, social and educational problems are discussed. And he wanted to reform the society. He was interested in reforming the society. Okay, so in his writing, he condemned the existing institution and portrayed an oppression and a corruption in the society. These two things he was portraying, the corruption and oppression in the society. And he was very much disgusted with the existing institutions. And he was in opinion that everything is good as it comes from the nature. Means when the thing is coming from the nature, it is a well and good. There is no problem. Everything when it is coming from the nature, it is a pure, it is a good. But it is the society which making them bad, which is deteriorating the quality. And that's why he was saying everything is good as it comes from the hands of the author of the nature. But everything degrades in the hand of a man. So he was in that much opinion. And he endorsed that return to the nature. What is the solution? The solution is that we must return to the nature. Returning to the nature is the solution. Because in the nature everything is a pure and good. When it coming to the hands of a man, then it is a degrading. Okay, so that was his thought. And he had written a lot of a book. He has written a lot of writing. Some of the famous writing was The Progress of Art and Science, that was written 1750. The Origin of Inequalities Among Men, it was written in the 1753. Okay, I don't remember that. 1753. Then he has written another writing that The New Hollis Romance, that was in the 1759, and another was The Social Control, that was in the 1762, and he has written A Social Contract, that was in 1962, and The Email, which was also written in the 1762. Okay, so these was the famous writing. So other writing are concerned with the other problems. So that we will not discussing here. We will discuss here about the email, because email is the writing by the Rousseau wherein he is discussing his educational ideas. And when we talk about the email, he talks that the education comes from the nature, man, and nature, man, and the society. So he talks about that by the nature he means that the physical environment. By nature he is meaning by the physical environment, because also we know that in the constructivist era we understand that the person can learn by the interaction with the society and interactions. So here he is talking about the nature is meant by the physical environment. In the physical environment, we can learn better. And when he talks about the man, man is the relationship between the social environment and the natural environment. That is the relationship, and the social environment is the man. Man is not like that the only the male person. No. Man is meant by the relationship between the social environments. And the third thing is that by the acquisition of their own experiences. So he was in opinion that the learning can happen by the, and the learning comes with the three things: the nature, man, and things. Nature is meant by the physical environment, man is meant by the relationship and the social environment, and the thing is meant by the acquisition by own experience, you know, by learning, by doing, by interacting, like that, by the own experience, that is meant. So in the opinion of Rousseau, the education can come by three things. When we talk about the email is a consisting with the five parts, and all the five parts deals with the different level of education. In fact, all the are the not a level of education. The four part deals with the different level of education, and the fifth part deals with the girl education. The part one deals with the infancy, and so how the education should be in the infancy stage. And this infancy stage is categorized by the Rousseau in the age group of 0 to 5 years. Okay, and then the part two is the childhood, which is the 5 to 12 years. Then the part third is the adolescent, which is 12 to 15 years. And then the fourth is the youth stage, which is 15 to 20 years. And the fifth part is of the email deals with the girl education. So all the level of education is discussed here by the Rousseau as per the chronological age of the child. Even in this book, Rousseau condemns that society for its evil, because society is for its evil, and demands that the child follow the nature, which is everything as good. Society is a place of the evil. That's why the child should not follow the society. They should follow the nature, because the nature is everything and it is good. It is pure. He also offers a protection against the traditional education, which is unnatural, unsound, unreal, and unprogressive, and favors bookish knowledge and the strict discipline. Because the Rousseau was not in a favor of strict discipline, because I have told that once he was beaten very badly in the school. So he was a sufferer of all those things. He was a sufferer, he was a suppressed person who was not getting a due respect in the society because of so many constraints. And he has observed the evil part of the society. That's why he says that the child should not be exposed to the society. And when I will be talking about the negative education, that time you will also link it, that the negative education is nothing but it is the philosophical thought of Rousseau to protect the child from the evil part of the society, and to make the child in the natural environment to grow. And when you will see this stages of education, like the five stages of education I was telling right now, you will also, it will also become a very clear when I will be talking about the negative education. So let it be. So he was very against the strict discipline, bookish knowledge, and all those things, punishment. And the existing education system was in favor of a punishment, in favor of a bookish knowledge, and that's why he was against the traditional education system. And when you will see his philosophical thought, educational thought, and you will link to the present context, you will find that even we are now talking about that education should go beyond the textbook. It should not be book piece. It should not be rote learning. It should not be, there should not be a place of a corporal punishment. You can understand how progressive thought and idea the Rousseau was having in the 17th century that till now we are unable to achieve. Even he was saying that book insisted on a freedom for a child, repeat for his individual faith in his goodness, proper regard for his nature, natural inclination and interest, motivation, and the recreational activity. Book restricts all the things, isn't it? And he was in opinion that the bookish kind of education, the existing system of education, should be abolished because it is unnatural, unethical, unhuman, isn't it? And this all the educational thought was in the book email, and it was a revolt against the existing system, and it was talking about preparing the person, preparing the citizen to revolt against the existing system. So it was a threat for the governance of that time in the France. Even Emile then, by seeing all those things, by looking at all the situation, Emile was criticized by the Parliament of Paris, and the copies of Emile was burned publicly, and Rousseau was ordered to be arrested. You can think of that, how the situation was there at that time when the Rousseau was there. He has come up with a so progressive thought which was not digestible by the people of that time, and their thought was criticized. Copies of Emile was burned, and he was ordered to be arrested. And because of all those incidents, Emile had brought a great effect on the thought and action in the field of education in the 18th and 19th century. And it was the basis of the philosophical and the sociological fundamentals of the so many philosophers in the 19th and the 20th century, even the 21st century, which you can say that in the modern education, it was the very basics of the philosophical belief. Like that, the Gandhiji's, you will find the Gandhiji's philosophical belief on education is based upon the Rousseau. Tagore, Rabindranath Tagore, he is the naturalistic philosopher. When you will go to the Shantiniketan of Rabindranath Tagore in the Bolpur, West Bengal, you will see that how the naturalistic philosophy is implemented there. Even the Froebel, Pestalozzi, Herbert and Spencer, even the John Dewey was influenced by the educational and social philosophy of the Rousseau. You can think about that. They all were influenced by the philosophical and sociological thought of the Rousseau. Then, when this thing of an incident was happening, then the French and Switzerland government have banned the book. Okay, they have banned the French people, they have burned the copy, and both French and Switzerland, they have banned the book. And in, he was that time in the France, and the France government has ordered him to arrest. So he left the France. Okay, he left the France to save his life, and after 11 years he returned from the England, because during this 11 years he was wandering from one country to the another country, and after 11 years he returned to the France, and he wrote his last book that was named as a Confession. And in the Confession, because he was struggling, he has seen so many political, sociological, educational problems in his life. He has faced so much of a trouble because of his progressive thought. You don't think that always the progressive thought which you have will bring a pleasure in your life. No, it is not always. If it is a too progressive, then you have to suffer. And that was the situation with the Rousseau. And in the year of 1778, he died due to the sudden attack of thrombosis. However, someone believed that he was not died due to the attack of thrombosis. He was attempt to suicide by the Rousseau himself. Okay, so this was the story, this was the life of the Rousseau when we talk about the great philosopher of the 18th century. Okay, so that was about the Rousseau. Now, before coming to the other part of the philosophy of Rousseau, we will see about the negative education that the Rousseau was proposing, the negative education. Okay, and the negative education is a very interesting philosophy, very interesting practice that was proposed by the Rousseau. And you don't think that the negative education means that we have to train, we have to educate the child negatively or the bad habits. No, he was not in position. Or the evils. No, he was not like that. Because he was saying that the society is a place. Society is a place which is a full of evil. And the nature is as good as. So the man, when it is coming to the society, they are developing the bad habits. Then they are becoming the evil. When they are in the nature, then they are good. And that was the philosophy, basic assumption behind the negative education philosophy. Together with one more thing was that the age of the child. Like that now we used to say that when the child is in the teenage, you understand, 13 to 19. That age is a very dangerous, because at that time the child is very much influenced by and attracted by anything. It is a very easy to attract the child, because so many psychological, biological changes are happening at that time. So many hormones are also secreting from the body, and so many changes are happening. That's why that age is a very critical. Even nowadays we also think, and when it is established by, now it is established by the psychologist, biologist, that so many changes happens which are responsible for the varied behavior of the child during the teenage. And Rousseau was also in opinion that the age of a child from his birth up to the age of 12 years is a very crucial. Is a very crucial. And in this age, it is a very easy to attract the child toward the evil. So if we can save the child during this age group, then we can make a child very sound, close to the nature and good. So Rousseau was proposing a modality of a saving a child from these evil in that age group. It was not a negative in the sense that the negatively we have to talk, teach. Isn't it? That was not the main purpose of a negative education. It was a modality to save the child from the evil of a society. And two assumptions was there. One assumption was that 0 to 12 year age of a child is a very crucial. So that time the child needed to be saved. The second thing was that the existing practices of education was not sound, unhuman. So we should save the child from those things. And by the term negative education, Rousseau mean that it is a way of aversion from the formal education prevailing in the society. Hana? Jo, it was a negation, disagreement. It was a disagreement from the formal education which was existing in the society. That was the negative education. It was not a negative in that sense. It was opposing the prevailing education system that was happening in the society at that time. And he regarded it as unwanted and against the nature of a child, which was prevailing in the education system. It is unwanted, not necessary, and against the nature of a child. And he had an opinion that the child is good, but the society makes him bad. It is the society which is making the child. And therefore, he advocates the negative education. And in the negative education, he was talking about the child should be segregated from the society and he should be allowed to live in the nature so that he will develop the sound body and a sound mind. And when he will attain the age of 12 years, then he will be brought in the formal education system. By that time, his body and a mind will be strong to judge which is good and which is bad, and he will be ready to learn. The negative education consists not teaching virtue or truth, but preventing the hurt from the bad activities, criminal activities, undesirable activities, and mind from the error. It is not a modality to train and teach the student. Rather than, it is a modality to prevent the hurt of the child from the bad practices and mind from the error. Okay, and in that sense, the negative education is a preventive education for life, not a preparing education. Like that, whatever the education we have now, we are preparing the child for the life. We are teaching them skills, we are giving them knowledge, we are making them understand, we are developing this. So many things. Why we are doing all those things? To prepare the child for life. But the negative education is a preventive education, wherein we prevent the child from getting the bad things and the error in the mind. So we are preventing. He talks about that the age between the 0 to 12 years is very crucial for the child, as I was saying. So he talks about the education from 5 to 12 year should be negative by leaving the child to learn how to lose the time wisely. It's also very interesting concept which is given by the Rousseau. He says that the education in the age of 5 to 12 year should be focused towards live in the nature, understand the nature, develop the health, develop the body, develop the mind, so that when he will be at the age of 12 year, he will have all the required skill and the physical fitness to learn. Ok. Okay, that was the one thing. And he was saying that during that time, we should not teach how to utilize the time wisely. Rather than, we must teach how to lose the time wisely. You will be surprised that what kind of philosophy is this. We are saying that we must save the time, because time is precious. Time will never come back. He was in opinion that we must teach them how to lose the time wisely. So, by the term how to lose the time wisely, he was in opinion that during that time we should not involve the children in the teaching, learning and doing all the activities, learning the moral things and the ethical things and all those things, which is a process of utilizing the time, because we think that these are the constructive thing and we must do it in order to save the time. Rather than, he was that how wisely we should lose the time, means how we should spend the time wisely for development of the mental abilities, development of the physical ability, development of the emotional abilities. So not doing anything, you stay in the lap of a nature, learn with the interaction with the nature, isn't it? So that your mind will be cool and fresh and your mental development will happen. That was his philosophy. Hence, in terms of Rousseau, negative education means allowing the child to more freely in the nature, so that the child is able to perfect their organs of their body, which are instrument for acquiring knowledge, and protect hurt of the child from the evil society. That was the meaning of losing time wisely. Yeah, because if you will be in the society, you will be doing the work as per the social norms, which will inculcate the evil thing in your mind and heart. But when you will be in the lap of nature, you will be away from there and you will be as pure as the. That was the concept of a negative education as per the Rousseau philosophy. There is a distinct characteristics of negative education of the Rousseau. The first is that it is a time losing philosophy, not a time saving philosophy. Time losing means you have to lose the time. You have lose the time means you have to spend the time. Lose matlab aise lose nahi. Lose means spend the time constructively by involving yourself in the natural work to develop your body, health, mind and heart, so that when you will be able to learn, you will be able to use your mind at a full swing. It was against the bookish learning, because during that age no bookish knowledge will be given. The child will learn by doing, learn with the interaction with the nature and the society. So learning by doing, learning by observing is promoted. So there is a no bookish knowledge at that age. Even now when we talk about in the early age, there should be no bookish knowledge. The learning should not be bookish. Even when you will see the National Education Policy 2020, it is talking against the bookish knowledge. It was focused on the habit formation, like that we have a readiness program where the habit is formatted for going to the school. It is a process of a habit formation. It is not a formal education setup. It is a, and here there is a no moral education, no ethical, no moral, this type of a of education have no place here. There is a no traditional methods of teaching. Even the traditional methods of teaching was highly criticized by the Rousseau. There is a no place of a discipline. So child will be free to learn by the nature, in the lap of nature. There is no instruction, there is no institution. And child will be allowed to follow the impulse of nature. That is the beautiful thing, impulse of nature. And that's why when you will go to the Shantiniketan of Rabindranath Tagore, the classes are being held under the tree. For the school, there is no formal boundary. So the child can learn in the nature, because the nature is the true and the pure in the eye of a Rousseau, or better to say that in the eye of a naturalistic philosophers. And the most important thing of a negative education was that it was talking about back to the nature. And so in that way, it was a very unique philosophy, very unique philosophy.